walking around a little bit, and I see that everybody is listing out educational pieces. So when it comes to education, what do you educate people on? Let's not just list education as a service. Let's actually list out the topics that you educate people on. If I could have your attention. We're not done yet, so here's what I need. If you haven't done so already, if you've been putting everything on the big post-it notes on your table, that's great. I want you to have that. But if you'll transfer it to a smaller 8.5 by 11 sheet that's on your table, if you'll take a moment, our final few moments here, and do that, I'll share it from the stage. All right. So what I want to do is I want to share with you the collective work of the entire room. We're going to try to go through this as quickly as possible because we've got two additional steps in our process in getting you to having an entire year calendar completed. We're going to go through content catalog after this and then your content calendar. Now, I'll just say, and I use this illustration with one table. I'll share it with others. I know that education is a big piece of what RIA does. And my challenge to you is, there are a number of topics that you have. You guys are the expert. You guys provide all of these resources. Thank you. You guys provide all of these resources and opportunities to train people in real estate investing. And not just real estate investing, I mean, how to be a landlord is another topic. So there's all of these different topics. What the obstacle that you have is that you have 12 meetings a year. For the most part, I know there's subgroups and I know there's other things going on, but you've got 12 collective meetings a year. You probably have a number of topics, more than 12 topics that you can cover. So the example I used with one table is let's say you have 36 topics that you can cover. You've got 12 meetings. What do you do with the other 24 topics that you've got? I mean, at some point in time, you're gonna go an entire year without utilizing a piece of content on a particular subject. And you guys, that's one of the benefits that you provide, you guys being the expert, but it's also one of the downfalls, because if I come in and I'm a member and I'm looking for content number 24, but you're only covering content number 1 through 12, but I really need content piece number 24, how do I get to it? Okay? Thank you. So what I want to do is I don't want education to be this big umbrella, this big rock that we just say, well, we educate people. I want you to know exactly the topics. I want you to have that complete catalog of topics that you can hit on. So then that way you can look at your calendar and you can say, you know what? It's been a while since we hit that topic. We really should do something on that. Right now, you guys are just kind of, you know, pulling some stuff out of the air, and that's my assumption, you know, that you're kind of pulling some stuff out of the air, hoping that it may be a hot topic right now. And if you land on the hot topic, that's great. You had a great meeting. But if it wasn't a hot topic, then, oh, you know, what do? You know, for the next one. So I want you to literally have a catalog of content and a catalog of educational pieces. So let's look at what you guys came up with. So under what services you provide. Now, as we go through this, write this down on the big notepad. Put it in your own notes. Learn from others. Networking, orientation, subgroups, buy, sell, trade. I'm going to guess, based upon what I heard at another table, that's live in a meeting, buy, sell, trade. Let's work together and do a deal right there. Okay? Free web page, government affairs, buy, sell, trade again. Good, better, best. What's good, better, best?
Benefits,
okay. Call fire. Okay, announcements out to the people. So then you've got the national RIA, you've got newsletter. What services, education, landlording, property management. Now this is, I'm liking this. So you guys went deeper on it. So you got landlording, property management, rehabbing, appraisal, contract law, wholesaling, private lending, ethics, fair housing, finance, inspections, insurance, landlord-tenant law, management, marketing, negotiating, purchasing, regulations, federal, local, tax law. There's...
I graduated from PhD.
What's that?
I graduated as a professional.
All right, great. I'll leave that there for a moment. That's a great catalog of content, educational pieces that you guys can offer up. That proves my point right there. You can't cover all of that in a given year, the way it's currently set up. Now, hopefully, as you look at your calendar, you'll be able to say, you know what, we can cover more content and be more well-rounded for our members through the content calendar. So what products? Resources tab on the website. Free handouts at meetings. National RIA. Members-only Facebook forum that is moderated. How many of you, by the way, have a members-only membership site for your RIA? Great. I will tell you that one of the reasons why people quit your membership program, specifically when it comes to content, is that your membership website is confusing. Okay? One of the ways... I'll give this to you. One of the ways to make it not so confusing, do a screen capture video of how to utilize your membership website. As soon as somebody joins your membership program, send them an email, says, hey, here's your login information, here's your username, password. Put a screen, a picture of the video right there and say, click here to log in and take a video tour of the membership website, so that you get them engaged. By the way, the first thing you want people to do with your membership website is to change their password to something that's memorable. Very first step. Was that good? Okay, not good. What services do you provide? Networking meetings that provide one-on-one solutions with experienced investors, generalized information on real estate investing, methods, techniques, specialized information, both general and specialized networking opportunities, focus groups in landlording, creative finance, and advanced investor trends, products that you provide, glossary of real estate terms, forms, done-for-you documents, that's great, videos on YouTube. By the way, are those videos, are they behind your membership curtain, or can anybody get them?
Anybody can get them, but they don't have them.
Okay. Okay, I put them behind a curtain. I put them there and just, this is for members only. It lets them know they can't have access to that unless they're a member. It's a members only benefit. Products, various educational topics, blogs, website with calendar you provide. More, service and products, education, workshops, mentoring, one-on-one training under education, focus groups, buy and hold, fix and flip, women only, advanced investors, local experts, market analysis updates. I am not sure what that...
Success coaches,
networking, funding sources, connections, services, lawyers, wants and needs, haves and wants, charity, affiliates, vendors, business members, good, bad, and ugly, contractors, vendors, benefits for members, product, software, services, education, networking, motivation, direction, focus, testimonials, introductions, referrals, discounts, Home Depot, Office Depot. Testimonials. Utilize your testimonials in numerous places. Put them on your membership website. Put them on the front page of your homepage. Get a poster for your meeting and have member testimonies all throughout the room that these are testimonials that are going on. Now, obviously, you probably want to get permission to utilize those, but utilize people's testimonials in more ways than what you're currently doing it. If you brainstorm it, you ask me, I'll let you know some other ways. Products, education, course materials, blog, posts, forums, email, something, campaigns, websites. I hope you guys are putting these down on your own notes. National benefits, member benefits, sponsor and vendor exposure, meetings, topical networking, legislative code, women in business, other special groups, forms, leases, wholesale services, service animals. Okay, that was the first I saw that. So I was like, okay, how does that pertain to real estate? So I'm curious on that now. But okay, say it again.
If you're a landlord, there's certain laws.
Okay, gotcha. All right, good stuff. Library meeting videos, presentations, the Tuesday tidbit. What's a Tuesday tidbit? Who's got that?
We send to our members every single week a tidbit of information. Maybe on landlording, maybe on tax law, maybe on whatever. It only goes to our members. Our general emails get about a 10 or 11% open rate. Those get a 35-40% open rate.
Okay, good. So one of the things that he just made known and is useful, bigger principle, is actually giving your members the content in a way that they can utilize it. So one of the ways that you can utilize all of this information and educate your people is when you say, hey, we've got 12 meetings, we've got 36 topics that we can cover, which is actually, from what I'm seeing, you've got even more than 36 topics that you could actually cover, is we're not going to be able to get to all of this content, so let's do a blog post on this, let's do a email blast on this, and we'll be able to educate people through other avenues so that it doesn't always have to be at the meeting. And so then you put a blog schedule together, which is part of your content calendar. You put an email schedule together as part of your content calendar and say, here are the things that we're going to cover in the way of our blogs during this month. Here's what we're going to cover in the way of our email calendar during this month. And you're able to have a more well-balanced distribution of your content. So looks like the Red Rovers. Is that it? Is that your team name or something? Okay. Services, websites, meetings, buy, sell, trade, newsletter, PHP program. Now, Iowa RIA School of RE classes, process service, electronic filing of legal leases. I'm having a little bit of a hard time with the handwriting. Great speakers, legislative lobbyists, accounting systems, workshops, ask the pro, formal and informal networking, financial analysis, sell lease in the way of products, educational courses, accounting systems, vendor directory, library, video library, articles. I've seen library pop up a number of times. So let me ask you this question on library. How many of your people know how to utilize or get resources from your library? Think that through for a moment. Do they know like where they can go for the library? Do they know like what the library has? Is there some sort of new member orientation as part of your assimilation system that you need to add in that says, hey, we've got this library here? Is there some sort of focus that you could put on like a book of the month that you have in your library or some sort of training course with the video library that you can put out there to your members and make that service known to them? Newsletter, coaching, classes, speakers, memberships, and mailings. All right, national benefits, multifamily private education, wholesale, commercial, rehabbing, landlording, assisted living, these are all the different topics. Creative teens, is it teams or teens?
Terms.
Okay. Creative terms, negotiations, driving for money, video archive of meetings, social media advertising, local experts, mastermind to higher level, sourcing deals, local contracts and forms, goal. Special education, legislative updates. We've got a bunch here. I'm not going to read all of those. You'll thank me for it, right? I'll let it sit there for a moment. I think you guys can learn from it. You know, that's not a bad idea if we took these and scanned them out. Okay, we'll do that. So you've got all of this. I'm gonna let that sit there. I love this example the best. I don't know who did it. So here's my thing. You've got all this content. How do you break it down? How do you go even further? Now, one of the things I've seen from the individual tables is that you guys were pretty much working the categories for a moment. So we're going to talk about your content categories just for a little bit. I want to try to just spend maybe 10 minutes on content categories for a moment, because you guys already were, you know, education is a category, things like that. In the way of content categories, I want to ask not only what you have, but what is the done with you versus the done for you categories of your content? What is the done with you versus the done for you content? One of the things that I'm really loving about what you guys are doing is you'll have these buy, sell, trade meetings where we're going to actually do a live deal right here together. And we're gonna make this happen. Like that's a, you know, done with you. And in some respects, because you're working with newbies, you're almost doing the deal for them because you're having to guide them through it. Am I accurate in saying that? Okay, I'm seeing some heads shake yes. I told you, I know nothing about real estate investing. So you guys, but you've got this done with you versus done for you content. You're providing all of these forms. You've got a library of forms that people and documents that people can go and download. That is a done for you form. They don't have to search. They don't have to Google it. They don't have to go to some lawyer or anything like that. This is a done for you piece of product. So in the way of what you have on your table, in the way of what you've come up with, are there any more done with you or done for you types of products or services that you can provide your members? Evergreen content versus time-bound content. What do I mean by evergreen? I mean, evergreen content is something that you can pull out regardless of the time on the year. I mean, it doesn't matter when it is. You can pull that content out. It is great. It is valid. It is applicable. It's not related to the calendar. Time-bound content. One of the most obvious time-bound content pieces for you all is the legislative education that you share. It changes. It changes from, you know, it could be from one season to the next. It changes with every election, whether it be local, state, or federal. I mean, you know, so that's a time-bound content right there that you just can't pull out the legislative, you know, update from 2 years ago and plug and play it in next week's meeting. So there's evergreen content versus time-bound content, and there's process content versus organic content. Process content, you have to do this first, then this second, then third, then fourth. Step by step by step content versus organic. You know, based upon what I'm hearing with organic content on being a landlord, some of your educational pieces on being a landlord would be organic. You know, here's three tips on, you know, being a better landlord, or here's the five steps to processing an eviction. Five steps being process oriented. The three tips being organic, doesn't have to follow a certain suit. So let's take 10 minutes, and let's be strict on the 10 minutes, and if earlier I can do that, and let's just think a little bit more about these three categories here: done with you, done for you, evergreen, time-bound, process versus organic. Take 10 minutes, discuss it at your table, see if anything additional comes up. All right, so let's answer the number one question as to why people quit when it comes to your content. Why people quit when it comes to your content. The number one reason why people quit when it comes to your content is they feel overwhelmed. They feel overwhelmed. Now, they're not going to tell you they're overwhelmed. Nobody's going to come in and say, you know what, I just, you know, I'm just so overwhelmed. Now, some will say, there's just so much, I don't know what to do. That's one way of expressing it, of people saying, I'm feeling overwhelmed. But people don't like to say, I'm overwhelmed. They're just going to blame it on your content. There's so much. There's so much going on. Or, I can't make the meetings. How many have been told that, right? Yeah. So they're feeling like, if they don't attend the meetings, that all of a sudden they're not utilizing their membership, they're not getting the value of it, and in order to attend the meeting, in order to be a member, they've got to attend the meeting. Like, I mean, one of the things that you can go back home and do right now to increase retention when it comes to your content is make sure your members know they don't have to attend every meeting. Now, you want them there, you would encourage them to be there, but don't make them feel like if they miss the meeting, they're not utilizing their membership. It's a balance. You want them there because you want them to implement. You want them to achieve success. But you also don't want them to think that if I don't attend, I'm not going to achieve success. I'm not going to be able to do or have or to be utilizing this membership if I'm not there. I saw this. Overwhelmed with the amount of content. It could be overwhelmed by the amount of content. It could be overwhelmed just with life circumstances, whichever. We're gonna unpack it even further. This guy says he joined Facebook and Twitter and signed up with LinkedIn and subscribed to several newsletters and podcasts and download, and now Google Plus was calling to him. Feel overwhelmed. I hate social media, by the way, although I'm on it. So how do you provide your content so they can implement? How do you provide your content so your members can implement? The more you utilize tools outside of meetings is going to benefit your members more and keep them engaged with your membership program. So that it's okay again if they miss one or two meetings in a row. Now, I would say have a follow-up process or a follow-up system on the back end of it if they miss a meeting, that you're able to get the content to them in some form or another, or a portion of the content to them. But utilize as much and as many different media as possible so that you can get your content to them and help them implement. And in doing so, you create a membership pathway for them. Now, we're not going to have time to do this right here, but if you were to look at a brand new member and start just right now, start with a brand new member and build a pathway of what you want them to learn as a result of your content, what would that be? Like, what are the very... If you were to take me, I know nothing about real estate investing. I was to come into your membership program. I was to say, you know what? I'm thinking about investing in real estate. I'm really not even sure I want to do this. I'm considering it, but I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to join RIA because, number one, you're charging too little for your membership, so I can join no problem. It's not anything off of me. We'll talk about that more. You should double your prices, all of you. I don't even know what you're charging, but I've heard enough. Double your prices. I'll hit on that if we need to. But I come into your meeting and into your membership, and you say, Scott, you're not an investor. I'm going to take you from not being an investor to being an investor. What are those steps that you can take me through? What is that process? You've got all of these educational pieces. What do I need to know first? Should I want to invest in real estate by being a landlord. I don't necessarily want to do the fix and flip right now, so I'm going to be a landlord. Do I need to study how to be a landlord first before I go out and get the property? No. I see a guy over here. I'm learning. He's saying, no, don't do that, Scott. Well, then what should I study first? What should I do first in order to be a landlord? How do I know what price... You know, I should charge for my rent. Should I know that first? I mean, those are the questions your members are going to have and need to know, and that you create a membership pathway for them with your content. So if you were to take the content that you see on the pages that you've got, what is that pathway that you can create for them as a brand new member on and grow them into real estate investing? Another reason people quit, I'll just throw all these up here. Another reason people quit is they don't know what to implement. I just gave you an example on that. They don't see results. How many of you have been told, I'm not able to get my first deal, I'm not sure, your system doesn't work, RIA doesn't work, it's all your fault, right? And so I'm going to quit. How do you combat that with all that you've got? You've got to get them results. Unfortunately, in membership businesses, you are always going to be blamed for their lack of results. It's just the way it is. Get the thick skin, get over it, and here's the other side of it. Unfortunately, you're not going to be blamed for their success either. They'll maybe give you a little bit of credit, but man, it was all the hard work they did. And you kind of sit back and think to yourself, well, they really wouldn't have known what to do if they weren't a part of this membership program, but good job to them. Grow the thick skin. Just have it. You're going to take the blame. You're not going to get the accolations that you should be getting. So it is. They feel like they're not using everything. You mean I've got to use the library, I've got to use the membership site, I've got to attend the meetings, I've got the documents, I don't know what documents I need what. I mean, if I'm not using everything, then I'm not going to use the membership. Some of your advanced investors are going to leave your membership program because they're saying, now, I'm not using everything. You got them to the point to where they're now an advanced investor, and now they don't need all those tools. They could teach some of those courses that you've got. They have those forms, done for you documents. And that's where you need advanced content, going back to the membership pathway, to be able to say, yeah, great job, you're an advanced investor, but what about this? What do we need to do to double the number of real estate transactions in your business? Let me show you how to get there. I mean, would you know that? Would you know that yourself to be able to say to an advanced investor to say, let's take you from this number and double it so that you can double your success? Maybe it's not double. Maybe that's over-promising. Maybe it's, increase it by 10%. Would that be helpful? Having that membership pathway for them. So I told you that I want you to have a content calendar. I want you to be able to know what you're providing. We covered that in the content catalog, how you're providing it with the content categories, whether it be evergreen or time-bound, process or organic. Now I want you to know when you're going to provide it. So when it comes to your calendar, and I hope you will in this next time that you have to be able to work at your table, write down the dates, at least the dates, for your next meetings for the next year. And I want you to think through, looking at the content catalog that you've got, what are you going to do weekly to communicate? So we've got the Tuesday tidbit, okay? So if you could write down 52 Tuesday tidbits on whatever topics, what would that be? Monthly content. How many of you are doing a monthly newsletter? If you're not, you should be. Okay? I was talking to somebody during the break who provides a done-for-you newsletter service. I think you ought to look into it and see. I know some other RIA members are utilizing it. You ought to see him and talk to him about utilizing that done-for-you service with the newsletter. I know National RIA provides a quarterly newsletter that you guys can use. They also provide a monthly e-newsletter that I've been told that you can take that e-newsletter and send it out for as part of your RIA. You can own that e-newsletter that National RIA is providing for you. So what is that content piece that you're going to do monthly? I'd like for you to have the subject matter or the topic, because you guys have so much in the way of content, in the way of educational pieces, that could you take your newsletter and say you're always going to have a legislative piece in that, as a quarter page article in the newsletter or what? And, could you always do a market update in your newsletter? Can you always do a piece on landlording in your newsletter? Can you always do a piece on rehab? And then also, some of you in order who are already doing newsletters, to make your newsletter better and for everyone else, you always need to remind people of the benefits. The reason people quit is they forget this newsletter is a benefit of you being a RIA member. This is the members-only newsletter. They don't know that. They forget it. So I want you to constantly highlight the Home Depot on your newsletter, that this is a members-only benefit. Anything that is members-only, you ought to promote that and market that in your newsletter or in your emails and email updates to your members. In the marketing system that I talk about, how to market to your members, again, when it comes to quitting your membership program as it relates to marketing, they quit because you stop marketing to them. You stop telling them how good you really are. You think just because they attend, they are a member, you know how good they are, they know how good you are? No, that's not true. You gotta constantly tell them how good looking you are, how beautiful you are, how successful you are. Okay, so what is it in your calendar that you can do this? Is there quarterly content? Now, I will say there is some debate in the room because I thought December would be a bad time to do real estate deals. And somebody said, yeah, you're right. Somebody else said, no, that's a great time. So I want you to think, is there content that is quarterly or seasonal based? Okay, I was talking with somebody else and they said, content on being a landlord is really good the months of June and July, which makes sense to me. People are in transition, so that makes sense to me. Some of you might not think so, but that would be quarterly content, time-bound content that you can say, you know what, every June we need to do something on this subject because it's a hot button. Every January, the turn of the new year, or this is an election year coming up, so we need to do something on this content piece over here. So I want you to take a moment at your table, and you're not going to share this with me, so I want you to be able to literally have this, take it home with you. I want you to be able to write down whether it's weekly, monthly, quarterly, annual, and under monthly, I really do want you to put dates on your calendar. This is when our meetings are. Now, before you say it, I know you have to find a meeting space. I know things come up. You don't have everybody's birthday in front of you. You don't know when you're taking a vacation yet, next June, all of that sort of stuff. I know that. You have permission to change the dates, okay? I give you that permission. Just because you write that date down today doesn't mean you have to stick with it, okay? So go ahead, let's take a few moments. Let's put our content categories, put it on the calendar. Sound like a deal? Everybody clear? Any questions? Clarity? All right, let's do it. Okay, let's come back together. So my goal, as I said when we began, was for you to have a calendar for what you'll provide, when you're going to provide it, and how you're going to provide it. Now, one of the things in walking around that I learned is I've known about the subgroups. Some of our members who've been around longer said, you know, we've already got a calendar, what do we do? So you can learn from this because it's a really good question. Now that you've got a calendar, here's what you can also do. I want you to look at your calendar and I want you to ask yourself some questions to evaluate it. Is your calendar balanced on content? Is your calendar balanced on content? Whether it be content for, you know, landlords, doing a deal, fix and flip, whichever. Is there a balanced distribution of your content to get and keep all of your members engaged throughout the entire year? One of the other advanced lessons for the entire group is for your subgroups.
somebody was saying, hey, listen, I've got all of my content already put together for the remainder of the year. We've got a board meeting in December that really does this annually, so we have our content plan for the entire year. That's what we do together as a board. And again, you can learn from that question by getting your board together and running them through the process that I just ran you through and put together your entire calendar, or share this calendar with them and get their feedback, get their feedback to you. But also, what about your subgroups? Do you have a content calendar for your subgroups? Now, your subgroups are already divided into the categories, right? They've already got, you know, this subgroup meets on this subject, this subgroup over here meets on that subject, this subgroup over here meets on that. But for a good number of you, what you're doing is we've got this subgroup, they're going to meet, and this is the name of the subgroup. It's the multifamily subgroup, so it's for those real estate investors that have multifamily properties, and they're meeting on such and such date at such and such location. That's it. Now, you hope that's what is going on in that subgroup, okay? You hope that, like, they're getting together and are actually talking about multifamily real estate investment and all the facets therein. But I can tell you what's most likely happening in those groups is they're coming together and that leader is saying they've got something prepared they're going to share, and then possibly at the end of the meeting may ask, what do you guys want to meet about next month? Or they come together for their group, and even worse, what do you guys want to talk about today? And all of a sudden, that subgroup is no longer the subgroup on multifamily real estate investing. It's now just come whine and complain about how bad, you know, whatever is, the market is down, whatever. And, you know, all of a sudden you've got a rogue subgroup going on that you're trying to figure out, do I even really want to promote that? Let me just ask that. We're amongst friends here. How many of you, you've got a subgroup, you don't even want to promote that subgroup in your meetings? Okay, I hear laughter going on. That means people don't want to raise their hand, okay, and actually admit it. So, like, you have to maintain a little bit tighter control. One of my challenges to you is that you never give a title without a timeline. That's a writer downer, okay? It's not going to be up here. It's something I deliver in my coaching. I'll tell you, never give a title without a timeline. I understand you've got all these subgroups, and the problem is you've got all these subgroups, and guess what? They don't have a timeline. It's not that you're going to be the subgroup leader for the next 6 months on this particular topic. It's, hey, thanks. You're the subgroup leader. Congratulations. And you're thinking, man, I'm glad I don't have to find anybody ever again for that subgroup. No. You're going to have rogue subgroups. They're not going to be benefiting your members. You have to protect your membership. I come into your RIA. I say, you know what? I've been coming to your RIA for 3 months or so. Man, I'd really love to do a subgroup on this topic over here. I notice you don't have a subgroup on this topic over here. Let me lead a subgroup on this topic over here. How dare you entrust your membership to me without some prerequisites? You think you're doing good for your members by adding an additional subgroup. It's going to meet their needs. You don't know me well enough. You don't know what my agenda is. You don't know if I really believe in RIA. You don't know if I'm really going to follow your leadership. You don't know all of those things. So before you make somebody a subgroup leader, have prerequisites in place. No, you've got to be a member for X amount of time before you become a subgroup leader. And by the way, when you become a subgroup leader, you have these expectations, written expectations, like signed expectations, that this is what every subgroup is going to do. And you're going to maintain the control over that content. Now, I know you've already got subgroups. I'm not telling you to go back and tell all your subgroups this. start with the new ones. Start with the new ones. If you want to look for a way to implement some of this, start with the new ones. Say you want to start a subgroup, great, here's our prerequisites. Let me go write them up really quick. You know, great, you want to be a subgroup leader? Here's the prerequisites. What sounds like a good... You can do it for the next 3 months and we'll reevaluate. I want to make sure it's right for you. I want to make sure that you enjoy leading a subgroup. I want to make sure that, you know, you understand what a subgroup leader is. So let's try it out for the next 3 months and just see how it goes. At the end of the 3 months, if it's going well, great. How about the next 6 months? And just see how it goes. So you can do that with the new groups. Don't go in, don't go wreck your subgroups and tell them and come down hard on them and you've got to have these expectations and you've got to do this. Some of them have been in leadership too long, you know, I said too long, that's true for some probably. Some of them have been in leadership too long, not going to happen, it's not going to be healthy for your rea. Start with the new ones, okay? That's how you make a transition. Start with the new blood that comes in. I want to show you something else. It's a term that I've not used. It's a term that I use with some of my advanced coaching members. Is really what I've done for you is I've put together what he has. You can see it here. Can't see it. It's too bright. Oh well. It's a content matrix. That's what I call it. When you have your calendar, your catalog, your categories all put together, it's a content matrix. And he's actually got it listed out. Like, here's our program for 2017 and has all the dates. And then the monthly meeting program, the tabletop sessions, the Saturday workshops, the sponsor spotlight, all of this in a matrix. It's very easy to do in Excel. Joe said if you want to see it, you can go to his website. He's got it there on his website. And if you want to go to him and ask him for a copy of it, he might even email it to you. That's what you're looking for, is how to put this all together so that you've got a system so that it's saving you stress, time, energy, and money. All right? Let me ask you this question. When it comes to your membership, and as it comes to people being charged, as people are being charged for their membership, is there some sort of content piece, product, service that you're delivering immediately as they're charged? So those of you who have a membership website, one of those is you become a member, you sign up, boom, you get your login information. The membership site, that portal is immediately delivered to you. Now, because you're charging so little for your membership, it's very hard for you to do this. I think you should be doing a gift for your members. You sign up for my coaching, I send you a gift. It has nothing to do with my membership. You join it, you'll get it. It has nothing to do with it. It's a wow factor. And I want you to wow your members. We'll talk more on assimilation. As they're being charged, there should be something like tangible, not just electronic delivery in their inbox that may go to their spam, by the way. There ought to be something physical that you can get them and give them and put in their hands that engages them and says, I gave you money, you gave me a t-shirt. I don't know. It's something. Okay, that they get from you. As people renew their membership, there should be something. Anytime money is exchanged, there ought to be this, I'm giving you something. Now, I know you have events, you charge for events. Guess what you're doing? You're immediately giving them access to that. Okay, great. Think about it on the membership level as well. When they join, is there something that they're immediately getting? Set some deadlines. The calendar that you have, it's a deadline. You've got the dates. Now you know, you've got dates on your calendar. You've got to have speakers lined up. You've got to have content lined up. You've got to have testimonials lined up for that. And now you've got that deadline. You can begin working your way backwards to deliver your content with your members. I'll allow this to get in focus there. Take a moment, let you get it. I'm not a procrastinator. I just prefer doing my work in a deadline-induced panic, right? That's how some of you like to work. I don't like that. I like to have less stress. I like to have more time available for me and for my family. I like to be able to have hobbies and do things. I like to be able to go to UFC fights. So other questions about your content. These are questions that you can utilize to evaluate your content, constantly keep it in check. What do your members need? That's an easy question. That's an obvious question. By the way, sometimes you think you know what they need, you really don't. I'm not saying do surveys. I really don't like surveying members. When you survey members, it says you don't know how to lead them. I want you to come at this with authority. Okay, so I don't like you sending out surveys, you know, what did you think of the last meeting? How can we improve the last meeting? What was right? What was wrong? What was missing? What was confusing? You don't want them to think that way. You want them to know how great the last meeting was, how good it is. So I want you to brainstorm and think, have conversations. Before I came to this event, I signed up some time ago. Rebecca and I, we got this on my calendar. And I began doing research on you all. I began going to some of your websites. I began talking with people and finding. I was actually at a conference, at another conference, and it was during a break, and I was talking to somebody, and another person walked into the conversation, and somebody just said, you know, so hey, tell me what you do. They said, I'm a real estate investor. Immediately, thinking, let's find out something. If they're not a REIT member, I can at least find out and learn something about real estate investing before I go in and speak to this group. So I said, really? Have you ever heard of the Real Estate Investors Association? Are you familiar with REIT? Yeah, I'm a member of REIT.
Immediately. I did some homework. I found out some things about your members. I found out how cheap you guys are charging them. How inexpensive membership is.
I'll tell you this problem I found out too, and it relates to content. I asked the member, I said, so tell me, what's the greatest thing about your membership? What's the greatest benefit that you get for being a REIA member? And they said,
the Home Depot discount. I said, what? Tell me about the Home Depot. Oh yeah, the Home Depot discount. It's the best thing. I get X percent back on every dollar I spend. Whenever I want to go, fix up a property, if I go to Home Depot, I just show them that card and I tell them that, I'm a part of this, and then I get money back off of that. I'm like, well, that sounds like a really good benefit. What else do you get? Well, we do meetings every now and then. I'm like, well, how often are the meetings? Well, it depends. There's a monthly meeting, but then there's also some topical meetings, and, it's on Saturdays, and sometimes I go, sometimes I don't. I'm like, so how has REIA helped you? Man, it really saves me a lot of money on that Home Depot. I'm dead serious. Like, I am not, like, I called Rebecca. I said, Rebecca, you got to help me on this. Like, what is this Home Depot thing? And I told her the story, and, I told her some other things and all that that I won't go into. I'm like, we've got to change this. You have to change this. Now, I understand that was one member out of the thousands of members that are represented here. But if I could randomly ask any one member that same question, and that's what they give me? Man, if you could ask your members what they need and what it is that is fulfilling them and making their membership worth it, what would it be? Here's what I know about your members. They face internal problems. Your members have internal problems that you can offer solutions to. Your members, since we're talking about real estate investing, have all sorts of head trash. Some of them are screwed up when it comes to finances. Some of them are screwed up on what their beliefs are and right beliefs are about being wealthy. Some of your members are screwed up about what it means to be poor. I love what Ben Carson said, without being, you know, political. I mean, he said being poor is a mindset. It's a mindset. I mean, here's a guy who had a worse off life than I had, and I mean, put his mind to work, put his brain to work, and said that if I'm going to change my environment, I've got to change my thinking. Your members have some screwed up head trash when it comes to real estate investing and when it comes to wealth. And if you're ever going to help them get to their first deal, you've got to address the head trash. I mean, you probably know right now, you can have some faces in your mind, in your head, that like, I know who he's talking about in my membership. Like, it's not about getting them their first deal. If I could just get them past all the obstacles and head trash that they've got and their beliefs, man, they could be doing deal after deal after deal. It's the head trash. Here's why it's hard for you to address it. Some of you have problems, those internal problems, head trash as well. For some of you, you never see yourself leading a membership organization of thousands of people. For some of you, you never see yourself leading a membership organization that is netting $500,000. Some of you, you might be even in here saying, if I could just get this thing to be making, you know, six figures, that'd be great. You've got some head trash that's blocking you. You've got some head trash that is blocking you from being authoritative in your membership meetings, that for some reason your self-esteem, your own self-talk is preventing you from leading your membership organization as you should. What I like to tell people in my coaching is I always want you to come at your membership from a level of authority. I don't care how successful your members are compared to your own real estate investing success. I hope you'll have members that go on and do greater in real estate investing, do greater than you ever do. And you prop them up. Their success is your success. Some of you feel inferior that you've got an investor over here who is kicking butt and taking names and doing better than you, and you're operating out of fear that they may do something with your group because you're not as successful in real estate investing as they are. You got to get past that. You got to see their success as your success. You got to stop the comparison game, even on your own. Another way that I would challenge you, especially when it comes to internal problems, is some of you are leveraging your membership and going after the quick dollar. So you bring in these speak to sell people, you put them before your membership, and the reason you've put them before your membership and the reason you've invited that speaker to come in is because you know exactly how much commission you're going to get off of every sale. You know exactly what's going to happen when people do the mad dash to the back of the room, and you're not just like the speaker is, like, how many people are back there right now? I mean, you're doing the math yourself. And you're leveraging your membership to try to get the dollars. It's a quick dollar. I don't blame you for it. I really don't. And I'm not trying to make you sound like you're manipulating your members. I don't think you are. You're trying to do this with their best interests, but also your best interests. What I want you to see is that you can still do that, but your motivation can be different. Instead of going after the quick dollar and bringing in national speaker where you're getting the commission, I want you to see the multiplicative dollars that are being multiplied month after month, year after year by that member. And so I want you to see your membership as a group of people that you've been entrusted to lead and to guide, and that you're going to give them the best value, and you're going to protect them from some people they need to be protected from. And you're going to expose them to the right people that they need to be exposed to. And that you see their success as your success. And that you can prop them up. And that because of all of those things, you can charge them more for your membership. You can. So by my asking around and doing some research, I've discovered that probably on the low end, and I'm going to use per month evaluations by this, on the low end, some of you, your annual membership comes out to be around $20 a month. Is that right? What's the lowest? $10 a month. $12.50. Okay. Crap. All right. Let me bring it back for a moment. $10 a month. I can't even buy 2 iced venti decaf raspberry mochas from Starbucks for $10. I can't. It cost me $5.94 per iced decaf mocha from Starbucks. $10 a month. Here's what I want you to see. Go back to that catalog again. Not only have you been entrusted with your members, you've been entrusted with this content. You are a steward of the content. The reason why people are paying you $10 a month is because you have said, this content's only worth $10 a month. Stop it. I mean, like, I'm not a counselor. I mean, you think I'm, I know I said I'm a pastor and you think pastors are all counselors. Like, you come to me for counseling, it's like I'm pulling a Dr. Phil on you. Stop it. Just don't do that. Now, somebody shout out to me, what's the maximum right now? I want to make you feel good about your RIA without looking at you. What's the maximum you're able to charge per member per month? What's somebody doing?
$50.
$75 per month. No, holy cow on that. It's too cheap. It's too cheap. Here's what I'm going to do for you. I'm going to pre-qualify your membership easily. I don't want you to have these looky-loos who are always coming in looking for the next shiny object that's, you know, not going to make them a serious investor. You're spending too much time on those because why? You're charging $10 a month. $75, I love it. Let's charge $150 a month now. If I'm going to make you thousands of dollars, educate me a little bit, okay? How much from my real estate investing should I be able to net in a given year? I know it depends on how much and all that, but just if you had to do the average of your RIA, the average real estate investor of your RIA does how much net per year? Somebody shout out a number. 100,000? Heck, if they do 25,000, okay? If the average RIA member is netting $25,000 and you're charging $10 a month. You see how ridiculous that is? Like, I'll tell you right now, we were charging pastors $99 a month as our bottom end coaching. $99. The average pastor in America makes less than $40,000. The average pastor in America is bivocational. The average pastor in America is taking his own money out and paying for his own continuing education. The average pastor in America can't spend more than $100 without board approval. Why did we make it $99? Because he could make the decision at $99 a month. We had over 3,000 in coaching, pastors. Some of the poorest people, all right? They don't complain. $99 out of their own pocket. On the high end for our coaching was $650 a month. Charging pastors. Now, granted, most of them, their churches were paying for it. By the way, they not only were being charged $650 a month, they had to fly. They had to pay for hotels. They had to be in person for that coaching. You're charging way, way too little. You might say, well, Scott, if I do that, I might cut my RIA in half. Good. Get rid of the looky-loos. You're not going to do anything with them anyways. You're not even going to be able to help them. If they can't pay $100 per month, how are they going to get money together for their first investment? All right. I told you I'm a pastor. I'll stop preaching. Go. Go. I know you've got to get board approval, okay, for some of you. Show them this. Show them this content catalog. Show them all that you're doing. Some of you are working less than minimum wage for your RIA. I wouldn't do it. Leverage your time. If you're going to be leading this RIA, what's your time worth? And pass it on to your members. The value is there. I would not say this if I didn't believe it. The value is there. You've got the value to be able to make it happen. So that's part of your own internal problems. What external problems do you face or do your members face? So here's what happens. Husband joins a RIA. Tells his wife, hey, I'm going to go to that new membership I joined. We got a meeting coming up Thursday night. He goes to the meeting. He's all excited about real estate investing. He's got to go home to Sally, his wife. No offense to any Sally in the room. And Sally's saying, uh-uh, you're not doing that. You're not going to go and do that. You're not going to use our money. You're not going to use the kids, scholarship fund. You're not going to do any of that. Like, Sally has been through the ringer before with Johnny, okay? Like, Sally's seen Johnny chase after shiny things before, and Sally's got to say no. So now you've got an external problem. You think you're dealing with Johnny. You're dealing with Sally. So you have to help them overcome external problems. Some of you, your RIA could just benefit by just by offering marital counseling or something for your members. So what other external problems, and how is your RIA, if you're really going to help them, and you're going to help them overcome, they've got those internal problems, and they've got the external problems. What do your members need, but they don't know they need? I come into your RIA, I say, I need this. You should immediately say to me, no, you don't. You need this over here. And then what do your members really need? How will you deliver your content? You should be providing your content in as many modalities as possible. If you send them a physical newsletter, you should send them the digital PDF of that newsletter. If you record your meetings, you should not only send them the audio of the meetings or the video of the meetings, you should give them the transcript of the meetings. Rev.com, R-E-V.com. No, it's not a reverend. It's how you get transcriptions. They turn it around in 24 hours. What if you took that? Now you've got another content piece. Now you can put together an ebook or something else and repurpose that content. I'll talk about repurposing in a moment. But all the different modalities as possible. Digital, hard copy, online, offline. When you charge more, by the way, you can do this. You can send them a monthly mailing, a member's bonus kit every single month. So that way, if they miss the meeting, they know I'm going to get the audio recording of it. If I miss the meeting, I'm going to get the online audios and videos, or I'm going to get the transcript that I can read. So now, if I miss a meeting, it's not like I'm not utilizing my membership. I mean, out of a given year, out of 12 months out of the year, I'm probably going to miss at least a third of them. Something's going to come up. What content can you repurpose? What content can you repurpose? How can you reutilize that content? Some of you are doing the same meeting, the same name, the same time for every year for the past 6 years, and you're wondering why people aren't showing up. Give it a new name. Don't change a thing but the name. I give you permission. You can do that. All right, inject some new lifeblood in it. Instead of calling it by the whatever name, your newsletter, give it a new one. It's new and improved. How many want to buy something new and improved as opposed to the old and worn out? Of course we want new and improved. We've been conditioned that way. So what content do other people have that you can provide? What content do other people have that you can provide? So in building up for your events, how many of you ask your speakers, and you don't have to show your hands on this one, but how many of you ask your speakers, hey, I'm going to promote this. What promotional emails do you have? What promotional materials do you have? What postcards do you have? What ebooks do you have? What lead generators do you have so that I can promote this and utilize their content even more? When you've got a speaker, build something into your contract. We want to be able to video this. We want to be able to repurpose it. Ultimately, those questions come down to how can you create more value for your members? And after our time together, you really shouldn't even be asking yourself that. You've already got too much value for too little investment. Just because you said it once doesn't mean it shouldn't be said again and again. Again and again and again. One of the reasons, again, why I use this thing that's called an Elmo is because I know when you leave this event, you're going to forget about 90% of what I shared with you. Now, for those of you who are writing it down, word for word, even more. I was glad to see somebody else is actually, from what I can see, they're actually audio recording this for themselves. You lose it. So you see it, you hear it, you write it down. Those are all ways that you can capture it. But for the general person who is here, leaves here, 90%, you're going to forget. When you do a meeting, the next day, they're going to forget 90% of what happened at the meeting or what was said. So you've got to tell them again and again. And if your content is good, if your content is applicable, if your content is valuable, why shouldn't you tell them again and again? Why shouldn't they hear you say it over and over? Some of you, I mean, like, you're on content overload with your own content, and like, they need to be told the basics again. You think advanced investors don't need the basics. Some of them probably need the basics again. They make mistakes. They make mistakes. So here's the power of repetition graphic. Power of repetition. See, most people, they come in, there's training, skills improve, but then over time, drop off. This is where they end up. They're a little bit ahead of where they used to be, but not much. So then they coast for a little bit. They go to training. Skill is improved, but they drop off. And then they're here again. Now, this is not a bad place to be. It took a lot of work to get here. They're not where they used to be, but they've gone up. And so then they coast a little bit, skill is improved, and then they drop off. That's why we have things have to be repeated to us. We have to be told over and over and over again. It's the power of repetition. We need it. We need coaching. You need this event every year to come in and go to work on your business. Now, I'm going to invite you. I told you at the very beginning, this is it. I invite you to be a part of my coaching. I invite you to be a part of my online course with the 7 systems of a growing membership business. I invite you to see how I treat members so that you can literally take what I do and do it for your members. I'm not going to raise my prices on you. I won't do that. I told you to do that. You can do that. So let me do this. Tina, if you would, and a couple of people that you've selected to help you. I've got some response forms. Tina's going to pass out. What do you get with my course, my online course? You get 8 learning modules. It's in a membership site. It's in a secure membership site so that you log in, and I show you exactly what to do. You say, well, there's 7 systems, there's 8 modules. Why is that? Well, there's 8 modules because one of them is an overview. I tell you, here's what you're going to go through. I map out my coaching process for you. I map out my online course for you so that you can go through it. Yes, I start you with the content system. Yes, I've shared with you the content system. Tomorrow I'm going to share with you the assimilation system, but again, you need to be told over and over. You need to go through the exercises again and again. Not to mention, there's 5 other systems that you're not even going to hear about while I'm here. You get a monthly coaching call with me. You get a private membership group where you can go online into the membership site. Using a Facebook plugin that I've got, you can begin to post your challenges and get others to speak back to you as a membership business owner. You get private documents and preferred providers. When I start to tell you about newsletters, I can give you recommendations. There's a person here that I mentioned already who does done-for-you newsletters. You come to me and you say, hey, I need somebody who's going to help me with this or help me with that. I will help you find that. Somebody to develop a membership site for you, whatever it may be. Get unlimited email access to me. When I see an email come in from one of my members, they get priority. You'll get a fast implementation coaching call. And here's what I'll do for Rhea is I will limit the fast implementation coaching call to only Rhea members. Okay? To only Rhea members. So we'll meet together again through that implementation call and take things step further. You'll get my Membership Gold monthly newsletter. All of that, if you added it all up, the amazing value, $6,377. But as you know, these speakers, we never charge that. We show you that. So your investment today, $997. That's it. $997. Now, I'm telling you that, but I want you to scratch it out. Because Rebecca and I had a conversation, and I want you to know, like, $997, if I do a webinar or what, I will offer it at $997. But Rebecca and I talked, and she said to me, she said, Scott, and you can ask her this, I'm not putting words in her mouth, I don't see her, but she said, National Rhea, we want everybody to get this as much as possible. So National Rhea, through our agreement, is making it possible for you to get it at $497. Not me. You know me. You know me well enough by now. Like, I'm not going to give you that. Like, you know, you go on my website, It's way more than that. So $497 only for you all, and National RIA is putting that together for you. You should thank the board members. You should thank Rebecca. And I'm not making this up, and I'm not, you know, trying to be manipulative here. I am not offering it outside of here. So when I leave tomorrow, it's done. Like, go to my website, or next time I do a webinar, you can join it, but like, we're done. I'm not doing it. So $497 is your investment. I give the guarantee, go through it. If it's not gonna benefit you, you know, let me know. I'll refund it, no questions asked. I'll shut down your membership site, all of that sort of stuff. And I've made my membership site to where you can't go in and, you know, get everything and then take it and then go. Smarter than that, I've been around membership a long time. So it's $497. I did bring some CDs and DVDs. I'm not trying to create scarcity. I could only take so much on the airplane with me. I literally only have now 7 available. So if you want 7, it's an additional $197 for the CD DVDs. It is a video course. You get my mug, as if you haven't seen it enough already. You get my mug on video, and I'm giving you action sheets and taking you through each of the systems, and I'm running you through exercises, much like I've done here. And you know, you've got those action sheets, and I'm guiding you through the process. And I'm gonna help you get new members, increase retention, and keep people from quitting. So it's available today, I'm here tomorrow. If you have questions about it, I'll be at the back. Hopefully, you have already seen how many new members, or how many members, if you were able to keep from quitting, would make that investment of $497 worth it. For some of you, yeah, that means 50 members, because you're charging $10. Okay? I'll help you through it. I'll guide you through the transitions. All right, so that's it for me for today. Tomorrow, we're going to talk about assimilation and why people quit, and then I've got a bonus session, if time allows, depending upon how much we get through. And one thing about that, it does also say in there, just to acknowledge it, you do get my online, my ongoing coaching every month as part of it. So you do get me coaching you throughout the month. You can cancel at any time. That's an additional $297 per month, 30 days from the time that your membership begins. So, yeah. What's that? Today it's free, and you get the fast implementation call. That's free. So, all right. Rebecca, we've got somebody coming up. And some announcements. Don't go anywhere. I'm not asking for a mad dash to the back of the room. See, I know you guys have been manipulated, all that. Did I keep my promise to you at least? Did I give you the how and not just the why or the what? Yeah, all good.